Hi. So, how do you open? How do I open the phone chocolate bar? Okay. I love my chocolate bar. My mom doesn't really let me eat the whole entire chocolate bar. You, I like it. You nuts.
Get it, Tucker. See, Jerry likes it.
Cause she dumb. Hurry, hang over and smicking before she eats these. Hey.
Hey, you two, come here.
What?
Are you ready? Tucker, here. Come on. Switch spots on me. Alright. Didn't even let me put it down. Tucker, here. Journey. Tucker here. Chicken. Ready? One, two, three. Good catch. Tucker.
Dudes, welcome to Draw My Life. My name is Roy Wasabi. Let's get this started. Alright, I was born in an island in the Pacific Ocean called the Philippines, which makes me full Filipino. If you guys know where Manila is in the map, it's right here. And I was born right here, which is a 4-hour drive from Manila, in a place called Pangasinan, specifically Dagupan City. When I was a little baby, I had a big giant head, which I was cool with because I didn't really care because I was a baby. But dude, I had a big head. But I was a super happy baby. That was my dad, that's my mom, and that's me. That's us living in the Philippines until I was 2 years old when my mom got a job in the United States. So we moved all the way from the Philippines to the state of North. Durham. Go Bull City. North Carolina's pretty cool because Michael Jordan played college basketball over there. Also, the Wright brothers flew the first airplane there. So, you go, girl. My mom got this job at this health place helping patients. I forgot what you did. Sorry, Mom. But eventually, she ended up working at Duke Hospital as a registered nurse. And my dad took care of me while my mom was working. He doesn't have hair now. Sorry, Dad. But I'll give you hair. There you go. When I was 4 years old, my mom and my dad came home, and my mom was holding this baby child in her hand. I was like, what's that? My dad's like, this is your baby brother. His name is Raymond, except his name is spelled like Raymound. I feel your pain, dude. My name is spelled wrong also. I remember holding my little brother, and I was like, dude, you cool, bruh. I remember the first day of school was the most horriblest day of my life, because I've never been away from my mom and dad for so long. I was miserable. They were probably fine with it because they had one less child to worry about. But I was like, no! The first couple months of my education was so confusing because I didn't really know English. So whenever people tried to talk to me, I had no idea what to say because I was so confused. So eventually my parents signed me up for ESL, which is English as a second language, which is pretty cool because in the end, I eventually learned how to speak English and I learned how to communicate with my classmates, which was a very good investment. When I was in third grade, my mom and my dad came home with another baby child in my mom's hand, and they were like, this is your brother, Russell. And I was like, what? I have two brothers, what? And then Ray was like, what is that? During that time,
Lending Club, take control of your credit card debt.
So we just bought the home of our dreams.
Nobody freaking cares!
And my family wasn't really the wealthiest family, so that meant their financial stability went down. Plus, they had to take care of three of us, so what did they do? They sent the three of us back to the Philippines, so that way our relatives and grandmas and grandpas could take care of us over there. I was extremely overwhelmed because the culture in the Philippines is so much different from the United States. People would talk to me in different languages, and I just didn't know how to respond. There was this one time when we were at this grocery department store thing. I just climbed on my mom because I was so scared. And Russell and Raymond were so young, they don't really care about anything, so they're just like, chill. Then the saddest part came when my mom and dad had to leave to go back to the United States. We were just crying everywhere because we didn't know when we were going to see our mom and dads again. Of course, Russell was young, so he was like, yeah, whatever. But luckily, I had such good relatives and uncles and aunts and grandmas and grandpas. I just felt so loved. I remember before my parents left, my mom and my grandma were trying to sign me up for this private school. And I had to take this written exam for me to even get into the private school. I had no idea how to answer any of those questions they gave me, so I just cried the whole time. Like, the principal came in one time, and she saw me crying, and she felt so bad. And she was like, okay, why is he crying? Whatever, just pass him. You pass. My mom and my grandma were so happy. But being in a new school in a new country felt like kindergarten again because everyone was trying to talk to me. I didn't know how to respond. But eventually, I made two of the closest friends in the Philippines, which made everything a lot better. Thank you, Elmer and Ellie, for everything. Then 2 years later, my dad came back to bring us home. I remember that moment because it was so emotional because we haven't seen him in so long. I was like, Daddy! And then Raymond was like, Daddy! Russell was like, Daddy! But that meant saying goodbye to all the close friends and family that I grew up close to over the past 2 years. Which pretty much sucks, but it's alright. I still miss them. If you guys are watching, I still miss you guys. So after 2 years, my dad...
So there's one... Oh! 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 of them on here. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4... 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Yep, okay, 16.
Once again, me and Raymond were so confused because my parents keep bringing these random babies out of nowhere saying they're our siblings. But, you know, it works out in the end because we're all pretty close now. There you go. Ariel's probably at the time. Who dat? What the F? I was at 5th grade at the time and new school... knew everything. I was so confused because I was so used to the Filipino culture. But the good thing is, whatever they taught me in the Philippines was so advanced, I was like 2 grades ahead of my level, which was a good thing. But I was still pretty shy. Then came middle school, which was pretty cool because I opened up a little bit. I wasn't as shy. I made some friends. I also did some sports. I did track, cross country. I basically did a lot of stuff back then. But I do remember this Halloween party back in 8th grade. I decided it would be funny if I came dressed like a girl get to her later. It was also in the 8th grade my parents bought this video camera, but they would never use it. So I'm like, I'm gonna use it. This is my opportunity, so might as well make use of it. So I made some random dance videos, lip sync videos, some random videos. I was in the spotlight, man. I also remember in 8th grade this guy showed me a card trick after school. I was like, that guy was Alex, by the way. I was so confused with his card trick, but he just went to another guy and showed him the same card trick. The guy was pretty confused as well. Then one day, I was watching TV, and this movie came on. That movie was called Jackass the Movie. I remember this one scene where Steve-O snorted wasabi up his nostril. Yeah, that was pretty ridiculous. I think that's how you spell Steve-O. Okay, there you go. But then I was like, whoa! That word is amazing. I played this game called StarCraft, and I wanted to make a new username. So guess what word I used for my username? Wasabi. Except I spelled it wrong because I thought it was spelled with two S's. That's why it's like that. Then high school came along. It was pretty cool because I had long hair at the time, and I knew I was almost done with grade school, so I was really trying to finish. My freshman year in high school, I wasn't the best kid. I wasn't too bad either. But being the oldest sibling, I had an older figure to look up to. So I really was trying to find the right group of friends, which I found. These friends eventually made videos with me. If you watch the older Wasabi videos, you can see them in like most of my videos. But eventually, over time, they grew busy and either working or they just don't want to do anything. So I had to say goodbye to them. But one person stuck with me the whole time, and his name was Alex. At first, I was like, alright, that's fine, that's Phil. It all worked out though, because we made some cool videos like Best Friends, Tarzan and Jane, lip sync videos, and dance videos. It was pretty awesome. And then I graduated high school, and I got my diploma. I was super happy, like, yo, look at this piece of paper, it's so cool, bruh. Woo! And then college came along. I went to community college at first because I didn't know what I wanted to be. During that time, we had 8 months of no videos whatsoever. Until one day, I was like, dude, I have this iPod Touch, but it's useless. I don't really like it at all. So I had an epiphany. I was like, whoa, what if I sell this and get like a DSLR camera and then restart Wasabi Productions and film with this camera? And then I called Alex. I was like, yo, dude, it's been 8 months and we have not filmed anything at all. So you just want to get together and film something real quick? And he was like, okay. Then I transferred to a university school. NC State University is where I went to. Go Wolfpack. It was very exciting because I moved out of my parents' place, I'm in college, I moved out, I've all grown up. I studied computer engineering. Little did I know, I had no idea what I was doing, and I was so confused at the time. So I changed my major to computer science, which isn't bad because I just did a whole bunch of programming, which was pretty bad and confusing, so I was okay with it, but not really too satisfied. Basically, I was super stressed the whole time because being an engineer is hard. I remember I called my mom one time, and I was like, hey mom, is it okay if I change my major or something even easier? And then my mom just got mad at me. She's like, no, you have to finish. I'm not paying for your college. Kind of bummed out, but it's whatever. On the good side, Alex came over every now and then, and we would film as often as we can in hopes our YouTube channel will blow up or do something, which it did eventually thanks to the help of Rolanda. It wasn't until we did the Call Me Maybe parody that blew up everything with Rolanda and Richard. At first, we didn't think too much about it because we thought it was like a random video. Then we saw 1 million views and 2 million views and 10 million views and 50 million views. Like, we were so freaked out at the time. We just did not expect that at all. And then I called my mom a couple months later. I was like, Mom, YouTube is doing all right for us now. Is it okay if I change my major? She finally said, okay. So I changed from computer science into...
Nobody cares!
Two film studies. Super easy subject. Oh my goodness. And then I graduated and got my degree from my parents. Because my mom's dream is for her children to get degrees. So this is for you, Mom and Dad. Then 9 months ago, I moved from North Carolina to Los Angeles to pursue YouTube and whatever lurks in that category. It was tough at first, but I'm just super thankful I did what I did to get to where I am now. So I'm extremely happy. You just gotta be passionate, be consistent, do what you love, and never give up. So Big Head Baby Roy didn't do too bad in life, right? But thank you all for watching my Draw My Life video. Thanks for the support.
Boom.
Where is my book? I don't want to be late to my first class.
Hey, what's up?
Pat boy, you scared me.
What's going on? Why are you so nervous?
It's the first day of college, and I can't help but be nervous, you know?
Goldie, you're going to be fine. I'll see you at lunch.
You're welcome.
My hands are getting messy! Comment down below, please. I'm sorry this video is so long. My cousin was just leaving.